Ito ang programang Bawal ang Tikon. Get it straight with Daniel Razon. Isama natin si Congressman Rufus Rodriguez, representative po ng 2nd District ng Cagayan de Oro City. Sobrang lakas mo daw na nalagpasan mo pa yung FOI bill na bakit ba tinawag na anti-selfie bill? Kasi,
well, misinformation talaga yon. There's nothing in my bill that would prohibit the taking of your pictures by your cell phone. First of all, you cannot prohibit that. That is your constitutional right. You have your own consent to get your own pictures, no? So wala yun. I don't know where it came from, but since kumalap na yan, so we have to explain that it's nothing to do. Our bill is just really to provide a civil penalty, not even a criminal penalty.
Okay.
A civil penalty for those who are going to trespass dwelling, and then inside the house, in the yard, after you break a door or you jump over the fence, you get pictures of the family. Eh, hindi naman tama yon, because precisely that's why you have your home. Eh.
So mas appropriate pala dito yung anti-paparazzi bill.
Hindi rin, because on the outside naman, you're on the ground, you can get pictures of the home. And then
what if, halimbawa, ay naka-telephoto ako, from outside ako kumukuha.
Ayun ang ano.
Diba? Siyempre, kung naka-telephoto ako, nakikita, nasisilip kita dun sa loob. Or nakikita kita sa loob, diba? Kasi yun ang mga trabaho ng mga paparazzi, diba?
Yes.
They're taking the pictures from outside, pero making use of special lenses, nakakakuha sila dun sa kung ano yung nasa loob.
Well, the second part of my bills, really, for example, the situation is, for example, that you are in a high-rise building and there is a home below you and you get telephoto, that's also prohibited. Kasi pareho intrusion din yan eh.
Uh-oh.
Although you don't go inside because you are there and you have no authority to get from the inside the house, then that's also a violation.
So not necessarily breaking in.
Not necessarily bringing in. If you use telephoto lens from the outside, like drones or something to get that is really a violation. Nobody would want that to happen.
Mm-hmm.
That just because you are on top, then you get some pictures, then you can get whatever activity of the family inside their yard.
So, pero not necessarily kung halimbawa, you went into public place and I took a photo of you.
That's not in my bill. That's not in my bill, the original bill. Mm-hmm. Nakukunan na picture. Once you're outside, you're fair game.
Mm-hmm.
Paglabas mo sa kwan, sa gate mo, well, you can be... There can be pictures taken of you.
Mm.
Because you're already outside, you're in public space. Eh.
So it's more of the privacy.
Yung
mga pinicturan ka sa isang prim. Halimbawa, nakita ka na pumasok sa isang motel.
Well, that is not, to me, that is
hindi
not also...
Kasama yun.
Kasama yun. Because mine is trespass to dwelling of a dwelling, not in a motel or hotel.
So hindi, basta hindi considered na dwelling mo yon.
Yeah, hindi dwelling yon. That is a public place. A motel is a hotel. It's not your place, no? It's for the public to go in.
Mm.
So dito, it's just really the family home.
Mm.
Your private home. Because according to England nga, your house is your castle.
Mm.
Nobody should be able to go there unless you have a warrant of arrest and search warrant.
Pero bakit naman masyado mong, finastrack mo na hindi mo dinaan sa committee?
Hindi naman finastrack yan. Ang nangyari kasi dito, we give our bill to the committee. The committee secretariat invites people, so we were invited as author.
Mm.
We did not know naman that there was no invitation to the National Union of Journalists. No? So on record pala, wala talaga hindi na-invita. Tsaka yung Photo Journalist Association. That's why once we knew that wala sila doon, they were not invited. So we have written to the committee, agreed, approved that we are going to write the secretariat, the committee on rules, the majority leader. Instead of having a third reading to approve that, kasi second reading tapos na yan, we will recommit. At saka recommitted na. Babalik na sa Committee on Public Information. And now, we will hear already the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, the Association of Photojournalists. Because we would like to see how it will affect. Because if it really affects the freedom of the press, then I myself will have that be withdrawn.
Pero basically, ang nilalaman niya lang talaga, because honestly, I was not able to read the bill.
Yes.
So basically, ang nilalaman lang niya, you're saying na yun lang privacy mo.
Privacy.
Yung pictures that will be taken inside your house.
Your house, in your yard.
O yung pumasok ka or taken from a point of advantage.
Yes, correct. Yun lang.
Yun lang.
That's the only two instances where there will be a civil liability that you have to pay damages for those who took the pictures for commercial gain.
Mm.
Now, They were saying,
so you're saying for commercial, naka-specify pa rin
commercial gain
for
talaga.
Commercial
yes,
gain.
For commercial gain.
So if it is going to be for, let's say, halimbawa, not for commercial.
Yes, wala rin yan. But precisely, the associations that I mentioned said that we have to define really what is private property and what is commercial gain. Kasi hindi rin masyadong define doon. So marami silang points precisely.
Kasi para halimbawa, pumasok naman, paano kung ipin-print ko sa dyaryo? Kasi commercial gain yun in one way or the other dun sa photojournalist. May kita siya dun.
That's also true. Siguro when it is for purpose of the public, I don't see it is really that commercial gain. I mean, I don't really... That's why you have to define what is commercial gain.
No, kasi yun nga. Kasi nga, yung photojournalist will earn from that.
From that also, correct. Oo.
Dahil kahit na pinablish, halimbawa, sinabi niya, hindi, nasilip ko si Congressman Rufus, may kasamang ibang babae doon sa bahay niya or 'di ba? Tapos kinunang ka ng picture pero sabi mo nasa loob ako ng bahay ko, hindi mo dapat pinablish 'yan.
That's right. So that's why to be able to assure each sector, especially the sector of media, we are going to hear it back and they will be given a chance to be able to comment on what are the provisions of this bill. And then we don't want to have a chilling effect on our freedom of the press. We want the press to be free to be able to do that. Except, of course, when you enter a private property, a home, and you take pictures there. Because right now, while that is a criminal offense, Daniel, because that is trespass to dwelling, that's already the revised penal code. There is no damages for when you get inside, you get pictures or audio recording. Magpa-plan ka doon ng ano, ng para audio, ma-hear mo yun sa labas.
Ibabag
mo yan. So, yun ang mga this bill would strengthen our right to privacy by providing for damages.
Parang yun ang pinaka-augmentation doon
sa trespass to dwelling.
Alright. So ngayon, ano ang mga nakikita ninyong naka-line up na malapit na napipirmahan na kung sakasakali ay isasubmit na sa Malacanang?
Which one?
On the... Na mga batas. Na hawak ninyo ngayon sa Congress?
Well, for the past 2 months, itong number one pa namin duty is the budget for 2015. So we're going to have already approved it last Friday. And then we will come back in October to pass it on third reading. And then mag-reconcile yung budget with the Senate, and the President will now sign this. We hope that this will be finished before December so that wala tayong re-enacted budget.
What about the cha-cha?
Just go to the economic cha-cha. This is the resolution to both houses, number one. Principally authored by Speaker Belmonte. Now, this one is good. I'm supporting this. I'm one of the, the movers and signatory to support this. Because the economic cha-cha will just... put a few words, for example, to make it to relax the prohibition of a constitution on foreign investments.
Alam
niyo, Daniel, kulela tayo in Asia and Southeast Asia sa foreign direct investment.
Dahil maraming limitations.
Because there's a constitutional limitation. We're the only constitution in Southeast Asia which has a limitation of foreign investments in the constitution itself. The others are by law. And so other countries. So by law, they have also been withdrawing that by law because kung law lang, you can amend another law. But the constitution, you cannot. So, ang economic cha-cha will merely provide and add this phrase, comma, 64th, for example, the utilization of natural resources and development is reserved to Filipino 60-40. So 60% Filipino, 40 lang foreign. Public utilities, transportation, communications, also reserved 60-40. Nasa constitution yan. At this time, that's why we see that many investments would have come for natural resources from foreign money, foreign capital, and also transportation, communication. But they cannot do that because they only allowed 40%. Now, who would be the businessman who would give 40% and they have no control? And it will be controlled by others in the Philippines.
Yeah, the majority.
So, yun ang problema. So, that's why that is a deterrent. That is an effect.
So, gagawin ng 100%
There has to be a law that will be called, kasi unless it's provided by law. So, another bill, after we approve the cha-cha, economic cha-cha, it's not yet the end. It just lifts the prohibition. But there has to be a law that will provide. To me, I would say yes. Give 100%. to the investment of transportation. Ownership. Communication, what's the problem with that? Mm-hmm. Other countries has opened that, communication, transportation. Mm-hmm. The big capital foreign can come in.
So pati give mga, employment. Pati mga broadcast companies ngayon.
Yeah, mass media. Yes, why not? Mm-hmm. I mean, in an area now, in fact now, you know, how many channels do we have in the cables? You know, you can already access all the media, no? So there's really, but in the age of the internet, wala na ito, no?
Pero meron pa rin sinasabi na wala na kayong ganun talagang ample time para matapos pa itong economic cha-cha. Whether it's only really confined to the economic cha-cha, although of course, they're saying na baka isingit pa yung political
cha-cha. Hindi masingit yung political because very clear yung resolution. The resolution is only specific, surgical.
Para dun sa...
Oh, 11 sentences, 3 articles, 7 sections. That is the entire thing. And only adding comma, otherwise, you will be not germane, you'll be out of topic during the amendments of the of this particular resolution. Mm. If you inject something not in the in that resolution itself, so you'll be out of order there. So hindi makapasok.
So ito ngayon, eh, meron pa ba talagang ample
yes,
time?
Yes, we have time, definitely. We have time. In fact, na discussed na for 2 weeks. For 2 weeks, the economic cha-cha resolution of both houses had been, you know, debated upon. Mm. More than 10 congressmen have already interpolated this particular resolution for economic cha-cha. We need that very much, Daniel. Otherwise, we continue to be last. You know what we had for 2013? We only have about $5 billion of foreign direct investments, $5 billion. Mm-hmm. You know, Vietnam has $21 billion. You know, Malaysia has $30 billion. You know, Indonesia has $40 billion. And then Singapore, of course, has $60 billion. So, saan tayo? $5 billion. So, that's why kulang ang ating foreign investments coming here. Kulang yung mga manufacturing companies. Mm. Kulang ang employment.
Because of this constitutional provision.
Hindi kaya lang, ano, ng executive or the legislative, of the people there to just bring, to just amend this. Eh. It is constitutional. So that is one reason it has been, you know, we have the support of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce. They themselves are being protected, are saying that yes, PCCI, yes, we have to do that because they see themselves that there is not much economic activity if there are not much foreign investments in the country.
So ngayon, nakakailang hearing na kanyo?
About 2 weeks of hearings na yan. So probably under the 2 weeks of hearing, matapos lang gusto mag-interpolate. Gusto naman namin na lahat mag-interpolate. Eh. Mm-hmm. So that if those who are minded to interpolate, I think when we resume on October 20, we will have more interpolators. So after naubos na yung mag-interpolate, then pwede na magbatuhan na. Mm-hmm. So that's the dala na yan sa Senado.
Sa Senate na.
Yes, we hope that this will be passed. Eh. Mm-hmm. We are already behind so much in foreign investments and so also in employment.
Mm-hmm. With the election system ba natin, are you satisfied with Commission on Elections?
Well, yes. By and large, the PICOS machines had been able to give us a faster and a more accurate count. I sat before in the House of Representatives Electoral Tribunal, HRET. There were those who filed protests, but when we opened the ballots, well, the PICOS results are the same as with the ballots. So we are sure that the machine are able to read very well the shading of the votes. No? So yes, we're very much, and then I think now, for the coming 2016 elections, we are just trying to have lesser. Right now, kasi there are 1,000 voters in a clustered precinct. So, medyo mahaba nga ang pila. So, ang mangyari ngayon, we are going to buy more machines so that instead of 1,000 people in clustered precinct, siguro mga 500 to 700 only. So that we have more time for the people. Not mahaba ang pila.
Tatakbo ka ba, Senador?
Hindi. We are not running for Senator. That is clear, you know, because first of all, our awareness rating is not very high. So we don't belong to the top. There's been survey.
Pero ano mo na ba? Pang ilang term?
Three terms na. So I have a break. I have a break for 3 years.
Graduate ka na ngayon?
Graduate na, yeah.
Sino papalit sa'yo?
Wala pa. We will have our party kasi is the Centrist Democratic Party of the Philippines.
No, pero hindi mo naman, wala naman sa kamag-anak mo na...
Well, it depends on the party members. Eh. Alam mo naman yung ano ang partido. We have a new party here which is a professional party. Our party, the Centrist Democratic Party of the Philippines, was given by the COMELEC a national franchise or authority to be a national party last September 2012, mm-hmm. just 2 years ago. So, yung aming party naman ay hindi ka basta-basta maka-join sa party. You have to go into a basic orientation seminar for one day mm-hmm. to know the principles and the philosophy of the party. And then, you have to pay yearly dues. This is the only party in our country now there is a payment. You have to be like a member of Rotary ka. Member ka ng Lions Club. Juice, Mapayad ka so that you have ownership of the party. Hindi yung patron. Patronage system na yung patron, yung big political leader, siya nagbabayad lahat, no? For everybody, and he decides what the party does. Sa amin, hindi. Mm-hmm. Ang amin kasi, we have dues-paying members, they own the party, the CDP members, they decide on the issues, they decide they will have a convention on who will be the candidates in the districts that are present.
Mm. So, ganun. Kahit pa paano, medyo ano din, makakasakit din sa mga balimbing.
Yes, hindi pwede yung ganun na magbalimbing ka. Hindi pwede yun kasi nandiyan ka sa partido ka, and then you should be there and you cannot just transfer to another party.
Political dynasty.
I'm in favor of the Dynasty Act. My proposal is that there should be no, there should be in the constituency, there should be no relatives on the, up to the fourth civil degree of consanguinity affinity in a constituency. I'll give you an example.
Mm-hmm.
For example, in Cagayan de Oro City, for example, there are two districts now. You cannot run as mayor and then your brother or sister as vice mayor or one councillor, which is the same constituency.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, there are two districts. If you are the mayor, your brother can run for the first district because the first district is not the same as the entire city of Cagayan de Oro. Okay. So, if the city is a lone district, like Iligan City, for example, you, if you're a congressman running for congressman, you cannot have a relative running for mayor, vice mayor, or council because that is the constituency rule.
So, papalipatin mo lang ng district?
Well, but the point is, as long as hindi pareho yung voters, there is no dynasty. Mm. Because how can you be dynasty when they have different voters? Like for example in Pangasinan, for example, Pangasinan, six districts yon, governor. Well, if his brother runs for congressman of one district, that's not the same as Pangasinan, so he can run in one district. No, because this is a multi-district province. The voter for the governor is the entire province. The voter for the district is just this particular district.
Eh, paano ko umangat ng senador?
Ayun, sa senador naman di pwedeng dalawa.
Yeah, so, limbawa, yung isa senador, yung isa governor.
Pwede. Because the senatorial is entire Philippines eh.
Kaya na.
Yung gubernador, probinsya, Pangasinan na. So pwede yun. Mm. Pero president, vice president, and senators, hindi pwede. Hindi pwede magkapatid sa senado. Or yung presidente, kanyang first cousin yung senador. Hindi pwede kasi they are banned because they have the same constituency, the entire Philippines eh. So yan ang ban. Senator, vice president, president. They could not have relatives on the fourth civil degree of consanguinity, meaning either cousins.
Ilan ba ang kamag-anak mo ngayon sa gobyerno?
O, dalawa. Isa is party list, si Congressman Maximo Rodriguez. No? He is the party list voted by the entire Philippines. Abanti Mindanao. Abamin. Mainly based
buong,
in Mindanao.
Buong Pilipinas.
Buong Pilipinas. Yun, no? Well, ako, second district lang tayo na Cagayan de Oro. So yan, nanalo siya.
So sa ganun, Pepe, sa tinitingin
niya, pwede siya.
Hindi siya masasakop nung political dynasty na nasa isip.
Hindi, kasi vote for him. Those who vote for me is only my district. My district cannot make him win. Because ilan naman voters ng district natin.
So basically, dun sa anti-political dynasty bill ngayon na to, sold kayo dun sa content?
No, sa dyan kasi ngayon, ban talaga for an election like 2016.
So ayaw,
wherever you are, ban ka na, you have another
meron
relative.
Meron
ka mag-anak. Ka, zero talaga yan. You cannot have one, two, or three. So under that, under the bill that is that has been discussed in the Congress, which will have difficulty in being approved, it denies a relative to the fourth civil degree of consanguinity to run in 2016.
Whether sa
national, kabuan, whether national, whether provincial, whether city, total ban yan.
Basta isa lang dapat. Basta
isa lang dapat.
So saka lahat-lahat.
Lahat, hindi na pwede. Like for example, yung kung nasukuan ka, kung senador ka, you're running for senator, you cannot have a
relative
brother relative to the fourth degree as mayor, as congressman, oras governor.
Or even sa barangay captain.
No, iba barangay captain. Iba naman. Iba kasi hindi kasama iba, sa election
hindi kasama
niya.
Sa
2016 niya, pero October yun eh. Oh. Hindi May. So barangay captain. Yes, my second relative is my sister who is the barangay captain of my barangay Cagayan de Oro, Nazareth. So I have two.
Oh, yes. Pero yung sa barangay, isang distrito lang din.
No, ang barangay niyan, it's very small. There are in my district there are 56 barangays. Mm-hmm. So she's one of the barangay captain.
Okay. So ito ay maraming malayong usap para sa iyo itong ngayong anti-political dynasty bill na ito.
Mahirap papasa yan.
Hindi lulusot.
Kasi in a democracy, how can you also babawal mo naman just because may isang tatakbo for senator, may isang tatakbo for mayor, hindi naman pwede tumakbo ng councilor sa ibang lugar. Ha? Sa ibang munisipyo, ibang mahirap naman yung ganon eh. We are also violating the rule of democracy and that democracy the people decides who their leader should be. But for a constituency rule, dynasty talaga yan eh. Kasi for example, mayroon diyan, mayor siya, yung vice mayor, kapatid niya, anak niya. Mayor siya, councilor. Yung councilors niya, kapatid, anak niya. So yun ang mga constituency rule which we in the Centrist Democratic Party is moving. So ngayon, in the proper time, sa amendment doon sa bill ngayon na complete prohibition, wherever you are going to run, basta relative ka to the fourth civil degree, meaning kasin, kasi first degree is your grandfather, is your father, and your son. That's the one degree. Second degree will be your grandparents, no? And then third degree is your uncle. Fourth degree is your cousin.
Eh, yung ginagawa naman na yung mayor, pagkatapos ng term, ang ipapalit na may asawa.
Ah, well, hindi kasama yan. Kasi hindi naman on the same, kwan.
Oo nga, hindi
on
naman the same
election. Pero, no? That's pero, a kwan na yan. Basta siya lang. Siya lang, yung asawa lang. Hindi naman pwede anak niya maging vice mayor at saka councilor. So that's something for the voters to decide. Pwede yung ganun.
Kung papalit na lang din.
Oo, pwede yung ganun.
Well, maraming salamat for being with us.
Walang pikunan. Walang
pikunan. Cagayan de Oro City, 2nd District Representative, Congressman Rufus Rodriguez. Dito lang po sa programa ang Bawal ang Pikon. Get it straight with Daniel.
Straight talaga ang questions mo, Daniel. Eh. Thank you very much.
Salamat po.
Hindi ba ako napikon? Hindi naman yata. Yeah.